What's up, guys? Sean here from Shooty School. I make the most elite Easy Drummer 2 tutorials on the internet. I had a question come in yesterday about the tom tracks on Easy Drummer 2's vintage kit. On any preset, you do not have isolated tom tracks, and I started writing this dude back. And as I got a paragraph in, I was like, man, this is going to take forever to type out, and it might not be sensible unless Easy Drummer's in front of your face. So here's my unscripted response to that. And a quick note before I upload this video, is this video isn't only about the vintage kit. It's just that the vintage kit is the most challenging example because it doesn't even have a tom bus, as you can see. You know, if we look under the Easy Drummer 2 Modern, Easy Drummer 2 Modern at least has a stereo tom bus, which all these five toms run through. But this whole method from this video is equally as important for this, because you might want individual control of all these five toms. You see what I'm saying? So even though I'm working on the vintage kit, this workflow works for 90% of the EZXs, because 90% of the EZXs only have a single tom bus, not individual tom channels. Some of them have individual tom channels. Let's bring up the drum kit from hell, for example. Rack tom, rack tom, rack tom, floor tom, floor tom. A small percent of EZX has this much control. But for all the EZXs that do not, this video is a valid workflow. And one final note just for GarageBand users. In GarageBand, you cannot do advanced routing in GarageBand. And this video is a completely different workflow than routing. This is exporting audio stems. So instead of doing advanced routing, which is covered in my advanced routing with your DAW video, GarageBand users can use the technique of exporting and isolating audio stems that I teach in this video about toms. Just apply that technique to every single kit piece. And there, you will have a professional workflow to mix your entire kit and have complete control. This is an advanced video, one that I actually already scripted out in a different topic about exporting from Easy Drummer. So this is kind of a jump ahead in my schedule of videos, but it's actually a really valid question. My answer to this guy who asked, is there some way to separate the toms in the vintage kits? There are no channels from the toms in that kit. And as you can see, there's no toms. So it's a valid question. The short answer is no. This is Easy Drummer 2, not Superior Drummer. So the quick answer is no, don't bother. Since this video is my response to his question, we're not actually having a conversation about it. What if he said to me, well, A, I don't want to spend the money on Superior to get that type of control, and I really want to do this because this is for a professional production. That would pull at my heartstrings a little bit, and I would go, you know what? There is a way to do it. It's a lot of hassle. It's a huge headache, but if you really want to do it, let's do it. And here's my unscripted video on trying to show that. Let me find something that plays toms. So I'm on the search tab. I'll make my power hand toms so we can hear toms playing. Sorry if it doesn't sound good. I'm not like prepared to do a super pro video right now. Let me turn it down here. We got our toms, right? Now, if we go to our mixer page, there's no tom channel. Never mind that, there's no individual tom channel. There's no way to control the toms. If all you needed to do was be able to control the left tom volume and the right control volume, as explained in my advanced drums tab video, you could just go over to tom 1 and tom 3 and right click on them and turn their volumes up and down here. This is almost exactly the same as tom 1 having its own mixer channel here and tom 2 having its own mixer channel here. So let's figure out what channels the toms are coming through. I hop on the drums tab, I go to kits, and I empty the kit. Now we have nothing playing, right? And let's just load up a tom. So that groove I had loaded up, I'm gonna hit play on it, but we're not gonna hear any of the instruments except for the toms, because we wanna know how the toms are coming at us through the mixer tab, because it's a mystery. Thank you. Interesting results, right? It almost sounds like there's snare bleed still coming through, even though I have no snare loaded up. But I guess that could also be the high end of the slap of the toms too. Who cares? Point being is the toms are coming through everything. The toms bleed through the kick mic. They bleed through the snare mic. They bleed through the overhead mic. They're coming through really well on the ambient mono mic. They're also coming through the compressor mic. So I would ask myself, what tom sound do I like and where do I want to steal it from? The compressor channel, yes. There's some great slap, high-end transient sound information on the ambient mono mic. I like it there. I mean, if you want to go crazy, steal it from the regular ambient track as well, because there's the room sound of your microphone right there, right? They're actually coming through clear as day on the overheads, and you can even see that they're panned out. Yep. This tom's panned left, this tom's panned right. That's good information to know before we get into this headache. It's weird, because I can hear the snares of the snare drum. And I wonder if that's just TuneTrack in the recording process being true to bleed. You're not hitting the snare, but you're hitting a rack tom over the snare, which vibrates the snares of the snare drum. So do we want that information? I'm gonna say no right now, but you might. Yeah. And I'm assuming the kick drum mic in this recording scenario, maybe the kick drum did not have a front head, so it's really accepting a lot of mic bleed into it. Or maybe the microphone was not inside the kick drum. Maybe it was a foot or so away, because this is the vintage kit, or, you know, a vintage recording technique. Let's say I like ambient mono for the attack transients, the slap. I like the overhead for the clarity. Let's just say I want those two things, even though the tom's going through the compressor's cool too, but I don't want to go too crazy on this. So what do we do? Let's say you've got a full song here. Actually, I don't want to go that far, but let's say you have a full song here or in your DAW. By the way, we have to use a DAW for this. If you don't have a DAW, give up. Do not do this. I wish I said that up front, but this is an unscripted freestyle video. Let's say you have a full song here or a full song in your MIDI track in your DAW. Go to your drums tab. Either turn down all the instruments you don't want to use individually here, and then you can just control click and get those volume knobs back where they belong afterwards. Turn down every instrument. Or unload each instrument by selecting none here. Or like I did earlier, I emptied the kit here, and then I just brought my toms back in. So there's a couple different ways for you to only have toms on the drum tab and only sending toms to the mixer. Now we need to isolate one tom from the other. We don't want just tom tracks. If you only need a stereo tom track, you're already all set. You could go to the mixer tab. You could decide what channels you want by soloing them. Let's say I like the overhead, the ambient mono, and the compressor. I could just export these just like this track, export as wave file. Oh, here we go. Let me loop that. I could just say track export as wave file. Let's call this tom stems, since that's basically what we're doing, is we're exporting audio stems of toms so we can construct them back together later. Oops, not the file name, cut. That's what I want the folder name to be. Tom stems. And let's call this stereo toms, because that's what it is. This is a stereo bus of the toms. So I'll save that, it'll export. And stereo toms, here we go. Here's our tom file. I don't have my signal flow set up, so just trust me, what this audio file is what we're hearing right here. I'll prove that in a minute. So the conversation goes back and forth, but Judy, I appreciate that we isolated the toms so we can work with them, EQ them, turn them up and down and so on. That gives me way more control than what the mixer tab was allowing us to do. But no, I'm trying to put out this track. I want complete control. I want to be able to isolate one tom, the other tom, pan this tom left, right, center it, whatever, pan this tom left, and EQ each tom individually because they're ringing weird. I want complete control because I'm a dictator. I'd say, fine, dude, let's make this more of a headache. I like the overhead sound of the toms, so let me only solo the overhead sound, and then I only want tom one, so I will delete tom three. Now we only have one tom in the whole kit. I've soloed the overhead tom channel, and I shouldn't have deleted this. This is it. I shouldn't have deleted that earlier. Now I'll export this file, track, export as WAV file. So this while it's a headache, but if I was releasing a song on a video game, which I've delivered many to, which I've done many Easy Drummer 2s for worldwide video games, then I get crazy with this stuff when the project's that important. So sorry about that. Silent. So now I'll write tom 1 overhead and I'll save it. Great. Now I'll go over to the mixer tab. I'll mute the overhead. I like the ambient mono for the slap. Now I'll go export. Where am I? Here I am. Export WAV file. Export. Now I'll go tom. Ambient mono. So AM. Was it the ambient mono channel? I believe it was. Yep. And then I like the compressor sound too, right? Now I'll export. Song is WAV. Tom 1. And this was the compressor. So now I have three isolated channels of tom 1. What the ambient mono mic hears, what the overhead hears, and what the compressor hears. And now I'm gonna rinse and repeat that for the third tom. So let me get our third tom back and let me empty my first tom, right? Now this beat's gonna export again, but just the third tom data. Mixer. I'll fast forward through this part, but you'll see me in the in the sequence do the same exact thing, except I'll just slightly change my naming convention so I understand that this is not tom 1 anymore. This is, whoops, unrehearsed, guys, unrehearsed. And this was what? This was the overhead. So here's the overhead. So this is tom 3 now. Tom 3 overhead. And I'll do the same thing for the ambient mono and the ambient compressor. Keep in mind, if you solely work in a DAW and not standalone mode, well, you should know how to use your DAW, and you can do the same thing in your DAW. You can be exporting these WAV files directly out of your DAW or directly out of the Easy Drummer 2 standalone song track down here. Either way works, right? So if I look on my Tom Stems folder, what do I have? I've got my Tom Stereo file, which we're not using anymore. Either that worked for you, and if it didn't, now forget about the Tom Stereo file. Now let's look at, we have three individual tracks of Tom 1 and Tom 3. Now, Sean, you put in all this effort. How do I make this work? Let me make sure I remember what this is. Actually, this is Starred, so hopefully I remember it. This is verse 4, Black Hole Blues. So now, Shooty goes into his DAW. How long is this video? Over 10 minutes. Damn it. I'm in Pro Tools. You should be in whatever DAW that you prefer. I'm just going to do a stereo auxiliary track, instrument track. Let me get Easy Drummer up here. Vintage Basic Kit. Let me get that beat. I was using earlier, I need the exact same beat because we're going to be importing the toms from that beat. But here's that beat. Right? So let me put this beat right here. Of course, this MIDI could be right here as well. Who cares? We all have our... I'm just trying to get through this quickly because I know this video is way long, but you know, it's a complex little detail to explain to someone who may not, quote unquote, understand, you know, audio signal flow. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to import audio. Go to my desktop. Tom stems. Where are my Tom stems? Easy Tom stems. Nope. Tom stems. Now I'm going to import everything but the stereo toms because we decided we don't need that comp track. We want all individual stuff, right? So what do we have here? Here's all our tom stems. Tom 1, tom 1, tom 1, tom 3, tom 3, tom 3. Tom 1 was panned left in Easy Drummer. Remember we were looking over here in the overhead channel. We noticed tom 1 was hitting left harder and tom 3 was hitting right harder. So let's make these ambient tracks. So control shift new. We have 6 stereo tracks. I want 12 mono tracks. This is tom 3 overhead. Now the right side of tom 3 overhead is right here. T3OH. The left side, who cares? Let's get rid of it. Get rid of this. See, Easy Drummer 2 exports stereo tracks no matter what you do. It's a stereo track. If you're only exporting, let's say, a snare drum going right up the middle, it's still coming out the left and right channel at the same time. So it's going to export you a stereo channel. We're exporting toms. Even though a tom is panned left just a little bit, and your audience perspective, so this might look like I'm panning it right, but to me it's left. If I pan the tom left 15%, that tom is still leaking out the right channel. Therefore, even though it's like a mono signal pan left a little, we're still getting a stereo track from it. So I'm splitting up those stereo tracks and just keeping the side of the stereo track that has the more prominent sound. That doesn't make sense to you, I'm sorry, but this is an advanced workflow. So this is Tom 3 again, so the right side has more information. So I'm going to get rid of the left side, delete it. And this was Tom 3 comp, T3C I'll call it. And you guys can see what I'm doing now, right? I'm just splitting up these stereo files into mono files so we can mix them like an engineer would. Mixing engineers not used to using a stereo single tom file. He wants a mono signal tom file so he can grab it, move it left, right in the spectrum. He can't do that so easily with a stereo file. It's possible, it's just a pain in the butt. Anyway, this was Tom 3 ambient. Now I'm going to do the same thing with all the Tom 1 stuff, except if you remember correctly, Tom 1 was panned left, so I'm just going to delete the right side of each Tom channel, and I'm going to do a little, I'm just going to speed motion through this to save any second I can on this lengthy tutorial, so here we go. Alright, so now I'm back. I didn't name this one, Tom 1 Ambient. Now I'm back. I'm going to put the Tom 1s up top because that makes sense to me. Now I have 3 mono channels of Tom 1 and 3 mono channels of Tom 3. Each Tom either has an overhead, a compressed track, or an ambient channel track. Now we have complete control over our toms in Easy Drummer 2, except for one thing. I only did this for one beat, but this is your entire song. This is a workflow for your entire song, right? So these should be tom tracks for your entire song. I would then go into Easy Drummer 2. Since we have our toms down here, we do not want to hear toms from Easy Drummer 2. So now I unload. This is the trick, by the way. Now I unload the toms from Easy Drummer 2. So now when I hit play here, It will play the beat or your song without toms, yet your DAW will read the tom information from here, from your audio stems that we exported earlier. For a second there, I was like, what have I done? But I shouldn't have hit play in Easy Drummer 2. I should have hit play in my DAW. Let me just make sure I know what I'm doing here. Bars and beats. And it's probably going to loop to, I need to get into grid mode. Let's loop this. Here we go. Whew! I'm going to hit play in my DAW, not an Easy Drummer. Thinking on my head foot. And now you're completely in business. You didn't have to do it as complicated as I did. You could have just said, you know what? All I need is that ambient channel slap, or let's say overhead instead. All I needed was that overhead tone from the toms, because the toms translated well enough through that. So let's just listen to only the overheads, right? That works right there. Or you could go crazy like I did and say, I want every tom bleed from every tom track, and then you would have 16 tracks here instead of 3 or instead of 6 like I have. But anyway, tom 1 was panned left. Maybe you want that panned harder left. So there we go. Bam. Tom right, let's pan that right. Let's pan that hard right 50%+. Let's leave our tom 1 ambient and our tom 3 ambient in, but not pan it, because I believe that was a mono ambient mic, right? Yeah, I believe it was the mono ambient price. So we get that slap back, right? And then let's say we did like the compressor channel as well, but let's pan those out to 50-ish. And now, unmute. And now we've really gained complete control over this. Like if you hired Rick Rubin to come in and mix the song for you, he might need this much control. Yeah, that's completely stereo, and you're ready to rock and roll. And let's just do one more thing. There's that note in that third tom I want to work out, right? It's ringing in a way I don't appreciate. Yep. So now that we're in our DAW, and now that we exported our tom stems, re-imported them, went through all this trouble, now we have complete control. So I don't like how that's ringing, so I'm going to EQ this tom. Let me just loop this area where it gets hit a couple times in a row. And maybe the head's attacking a little too much. The sky is the limit at this point. Now I can use all the dynamic and creative effects I want on these toms. I can pan them out. I can turn them all up and turn them all down. Bam. No, you cannot isolate your tracks in Easy Drummer 2 for the Vintage Kit or for any other Easy EX that doesn't give you those isolated channel tracks unless you want to go through a headache like this. And if you're really passionate about not spending a lot more money on Superior Drummer 3 to get this results, there's a way you could load the Vintage Kit into Superior Drummer 3. It still won't work out of the gate. You actually got to start adding individual tom tracks to the mixer, and you'll be able to figure this out. That's after a big expense. Or you can do some crazy exporting, splitting stereo tracks into mono tracks, isolating them, muting so you don't hear those toms anymore, and get complete control with this crazy freaking spaghetti mess of a method, which, as you can see, it actually works really freaking well. Anyway, whew, this can be a 20 minute video, but this is an advanced video. That's what you get. Rock on.